The end of the world is upon us, and it's all because of you.
What? What did I do?
You didn't get your customers to connect their receivers to the internet. It's all your fault.
Fault.
Brian. Hey, Brian. Hey, welcome back, Sleeping Beauty. While you were in Dreamland, we talked about a lot of good connectivity stuff. Well, fortunately for you, our friends in the training department sent us another video, so why don't you try and pay attention this time, huh?
Over the past few videos, we've learned about some of the benefits of connectivity, how to overcome connectivity obstacles, and how to make an open port available in the customer's home network so that we can connect the dish receiver to the internet. Let's take a look back. First, we discussed the benefits of IP connectivity. We want the customers to get the most out of their service, and one of the best ways to do this is to connect their dish receiver to the internet. With this connection, customers can make the most out of their current subscription with an ever-expanding free library of on-demand shows. With Sling technology, customers can view live TV and DVR recordings remotely, and customers who subscribe to premium channels can make the most out of their subscription by using HBO Go and Max Go on their mobile devices. But how can connectivity benefit our customers if we can't actually get them connected? The answer is, it can't. So the next two parts of our connectivity series focused on overcoming the obstacles that technicians face each day when trying to connect our customers. We know that customers do not like to incur additional charges, and customers do not like the prospect of additional charges. But not to worry, Dish has a fix for that. Customers never incur additional charges just for being connected. In fact, one of the best features of IP connectivity is the ever-expanding library of on-demand titles provided by Dish. If you subscribe to America's Top 120, you can watch episodes of Hoarders for no additional cost. If you're concerned about family members ordering pay-per-view, sleep easy. Dish receivers have convenient and effective ways to control the programming that's purchased and viewed at each and every TV location. But if you're intimidated by the router setup process or don't understand the basics of a customer's home network, you won't have the confidence to overcome connectivity obstacles anyway. That brings us to the next few videos in the IP connectivity series, which explained connectivity components and how to create an open port in the customer's home network to be able to connect our Dish receiver. Do you remember the difference between a router and a switch? A router is a device that connects and creates networks. It connects the World Wide Web to the smaller home networks we come into contact with every day. A switch is a simpler device. Whereas a router can create and connect networks, a switch can only connect components within a singular network. Both of these accessories are used to help create an open port in the customer's network. In an ideal situation, this open port would be used to directly connect an Ethernet cable to the Dish receiver. But what happens when we cannot connect an Ethernet cable directly to the customer's receiver? The Sling Link and wireless adapter are devices we use to provide our customers with a complete connectivity solution. The Sling Link connects one or more receivers to the internet by transferring the broadband connection through the power grid to electrical outlets. This is ideal when more than one receiver needs to be connected to the internet and is not in reach of an Ethernet cable. The Wi-Fi adapter is ideal for existing wireless connections where a Sling Link cannot be used. Since the wireless adapter generates a relatively weak signal in comparison to the rest of our connectivity components, it is almost always our last choice. But regardless if you have to use a router, switch, Sling Link, or wireless adapter, the main point of these videos is to get our customers connected. Did we make that clear enough for you? Good. Get out there and connect. Who knows? Connecting as many customers as possible could earn you a promotion, cash incentives, or even something greater. On behalf of all of us at DNS, we'd like to thank you. We look forward to an awesome new year.